pleasant good Tuesday evening to all of you out there in television land. Welcome to session number 15. Folks, we have reached the end of our spring semester 2011, regretfully. The bad news, we've reached the end of the semester. The good news, we're going to go out with a bang like I try and do each and every end of each semester. Can't believe it, for the last 9 years. I'm Chet Hanley. This is IDS 336. You've tuned in once again to Jazz in the Modern Era. We are coming to you live from the campus at California State University, Dominguez Hills, over LA 36. All of its local affiliates, including Forte out in Santa Monica. And we are coming to you worldwide because we are on the internet. It's great to be back with you for another set of music. We'll be with you through 10 p.m. this evening. Those of you who've stayed with us throughout know some numbers. They've been flashing across your screen. The toll-free number into our little room here, 800-339-1193. As always, I welcome your calls anytime between now and 10. Those of you who've stayed with us on your computer know how to reach us, dhtv.csu.edu. I'll get it right. You know what it is. It's just flashed on your screen. And again, if you've missed any of the previous 14 broadcasts, you can go to youtube.com/csudhtv. You can watch the previous 14 at your leisure. And roughly 24 hours after tonight's broadcast, you can revisit session number 15 via YouTube. It's great to be back with you again. Got some exciting things for you this evening. A couple of notes very, very quickly before I kick off with who you just heard from. Those of you who are aficionados knew exactly who you were listening to. You saw it across your screen. Again, thank you to those of you who submitted your projects. I have listened or watched several of them. The bad news is I have not received a project from a couple of you. And the fact of the matter is I haven't heard from you either. And you know what that means. As I've mentioned on several occasions, no project. You know what kind of grade you're going to receive. Now, I know that my phone will light up. You know my contact information, saying, oh, Hanley, please. I won't listen to any any excuses at this point in time. You've had plenty of time to submit your projects. I have to tell you that those that I have listened to or watched, nice, nice profiles of some very, very important musicians, including the likes of Dizzy Gillespie and Louis Armstrong and Machito, among others. So thank you for that as we push forward. We kick things off from the Village Vanguard in 1961, featuring the Bill Evans Trio, the master pianist, Mr. Bill Evans, out front on piano, the legendary bassist, Scott LaFaro, and drummer par excellence, Mr. Paul Motion, or Paul Motion, depending on your point of view. The tune, Miles Davis's Milestones, that's Miles' second version of that tune. There's another version of Milestones that I'm sure many of you are familiar with, but this is the second version of Milestones. Again, from the Village Vanguard, the name of the date, Waltz for Debbie, recorded live at the Village Vanguard in 1961, the Bill Evans Trio. We're going to continue now with a band that truly made a name for itself in the early 70s. Some wonderful musicians on this date, many of whom reside right here in Southern California. We're going to feature the band headed up by a bassist of renown, Mr. Henry Franklin. We're going to feature the title track from a 1973 release entitled The Skipper. This is the Henry Franklin Aggregation. Thank you. Just a little taste of The Skipper. That's the title track from the date entitled The Skipper. Headed up by the gentleman you see seated to my left, Mr. Henry Franklin. Working with Charles Owens, who was here in studio about 3 or 4 weeks ago. We had a ball. Charles Owens on tenor saxophone, Oscar Brashear on trumpet, William Henderson at the piano, and Michael Carvin on drums, Henry Franklin on bass. Folks, inasmuch as this is our last session, I try to go out each semester with a bang, and I couldn't think of anyone who I really felt could help us go out with a bang than this gentleman to my left. This is one of the great giants of the music, and he continues to tour the world. He is going to talk about some of his travels in the next couple of seconds here, and continues to record on a regular basis. We're going to share some of his more recent releases. Great band leader and one of the great guys in the business, and it's truly a pleasure, and I'm truly honored to have in studio the Skipper himself, Mr. Henry Franklin. Welcome back, Chief.
Were you talking about me?
No, you know I was. About 4 or 5 years ago, Henry Franklin came and visited us here at Dominguez Hills, and we had a grand old time. That was followed by the appearance of tenor saxophonist George Harper. And towards the end of that broadcast, the Skipper joined George, and they did one of the great duo sessions that I can remember. Yeah. So it's a pleasure to have you back.
Thank you. I remember that. That was fun with George and
I. George, yeah. That was great stuff.
Yeah.
Let's start, with, Skipper, I mentioned that you're traveling, you're playing, and not only here in Southern California, a gig you had for the last... 12 years.
12 and a half years.
That's remarkable.
These days it is.
Tell the folks where you appear and where you've appeared for the last 12 years, and talk a little bit about some of the places you've been in the last few weeks.
Okay, well, we've been at the Mission Inn Hotel. It's been for 12 and a half years.
Wow.
I've had a duo down there with different piano players. Mm-hmm. And for 11 years, it was 5 nights a week. And due to the economy, they cut it down to 2 nights a week.
From 5 to 2.
Yeah, that's okay with me.
Okay.
That's okay with me.
The gig continues.
Yeah, but okay. It can wear you out 5 nights a week for 11 years, you know. Mm-hmm. So that's fine with me.
Yeah.
It's still there.
That's great. What days of the week, Skipper? Is it
Fridays and Saturdays.
Fridays and Saturdays.
Yeah.
Okay. And I would think that the crowds are solid, and you probably have some regular folks who come out and see
you. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Now, I know you've been traveling lately.
Been on the move, yeah.
Talk a little bit about some of your travels in the last few weeks.
I guess last week I was in Seattle last weekend. Mm-hmm. With a trio we had called Franklin, Clovers, and Seals. We did 3 or 4 albums on the Beeswax label.
Okay.
And it's every now, 2 or 3 times a year we get together and do something somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
So this time we did something in Seattle and did a live recording while we were there.
Oh, wow.
So it's
great.
We had a good time.
Was that like a day, 2 days up there?
Three.
Three days.
3 days, yeah.
Okay.
I just got back yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
February, I was in Osaka, Japan. That's a gig I do, seems like, every 6 months now.
I'm
going back in July. And,
let me stop you.
Mm-hmm.
Traveling post 9/11. It's probably not one of your more favorite activities, the actual traveling from A to B. You tell me. Tell us.
Well, it's not. Sure ain't like it used to be.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
With all the security and stuff, you got to take your shoes off. You got to go through all this, and I've got a hip replacement. You know, so they take a special doing to me. You know, they take me over the side.
They pull you aside.
Oh, every time, man.
Oh, what a drag.
Every time.
And in addition to that, you're not traveling with a little piccolo. Traveling with that big bass.
I'm at the point now where I try not to travel with it.
So you play.
Have it situated where there's a bass where I go. And just cross my fingers that it's going to be a good bass.
Mm-hmm.
Good enough to make it, you know. But I've kind of given up on traveling with my own instrument out of it. On airplanes now.
Makes sense.
Yeah, I've had hard cases and put it in hard cases, and they still. I see the sign that says fragile, and they want to see how fragile it is.
Oh, they test it.
Yeah, they test it.
Not good. Let's face it, bass fiddles are not inexpensive.
No, they're not. No, we're not.
Yes, yes. We're talking thousands of dollars.
Yes, we are.
My guest, the renowned Henry Franklin, the skipper, is with us this evening, and it's truly an honor for me to have him here.
Thank you.
Right here in Carson, California. We're going to come back to some of the skipper's travels. What I'd like to do initially is, Scott LaFaro. We opened up with Bill Evans working with Scott LaFaro, and I know that Scott LaFaro had a profound influence on not only you, but so many bassists in his music. Talk about Scott.
Well, when Scott LaFaro came out, he just changed the whole role of the bass itself, I think. Because there were other guys before him, you know, Oscar Pettiford and Jimmy Blanton and guys like that, and of course Paul Chambers. But Scott did it in such a melodic way, and it just changed everything around. Mm-hmm. And things you could do with the bass that people thought it would never be done.
I wonder how he was received, Skipper, when he was doing the things he was doing, because that was unusual when he was doing those things.
People had to love it, because he was right on it. He was playing throughout while Bill was playing and playing his chords and playing. He was playing his own melody, you know.
That's a sign of a serious, committed musician who's literally changing the conception.
That's exactly what he did. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And since then, there have been other guys who followed, but that was his school.
Mm-hmm. You know? Mm-hmm. So you can say that. Part of the skipper comes from the Scott LaFaro school.
Well, I'm trying. He's a bad man.
Indeed. Henry Franklin is with us. We're going to continue now. Our first video clip of the evening features a clip I've shared before. I'm not certain that I've shared this particular tune from this video clip, but I'd love for Henry Franklin to talk about the basis that we're going to feature in this next tune. A date headed up by the great Stan Getz. Recorded in 1990, one of his last recordings. He's working with the renowned Kenny Barron at the piano, Alex Blake on bass, and Terry Lynn Carrington on drums. They're going to play a Kenny Barron line entitled Voyage, and then we'll come back.
Composition written by Kenny Barron called Voyage. Thank you.
Stan Getz Quartet, recorded live in 1990, as I mentioned at the top. This was one of his last recording sessions. I think it may have been his last video recording session. The great tenor saxophonist, Mr. Sound himself, Stan Getz, working with another great musician, teacher, Kenny Barron at the piano, Alex Blake on bass, and I want to have my very special guest to my left, Mr. Henry Franklin, talk about his approach to his bass in just a moment. The dynamic at that time, young Terry Lynn Carrington, straight ahead, stoking the fire at the Trap Kit, the tune written by Kenny Barron entitled Voyage. Henry Franklin's with me. Skipper, talk about what you just saw with regard to Alex Blake. The way he played was a little unusual.
Yeah, I've known Alex for a long time, and I've seen him in certain situations, man, like with Randy Weston. He'll start playing the bass and stomping his foot, and he's got his time. He's got an uncanny sense of timing, and the way he makes the bass sing. I love him.
Yeah,
he's very exciting.
Yeah, I was fortunate enough, Henry, to have his brother, Russell Blake, come in and join us on a couple of occasions. That was a lot of fun. That was great stuff. We opened our program this evening with the great Scott LaFaro working with Bill Evans. And in talking with you earlier, you mentioned that not only did Scott LaFaro have a profound influence on you and so many other great bassists, but also, for my money, one of the kings of this instrument, Mr. Paul Chambers. And I want to feature Paul Chambers working with this quartet that features Kenny Burrell at the guitar, Hank Jones on piano, Art Taylor on drums, way back in 1957, and this band is going to interpret a little ditty entitled Confessing, or I'm Confessing That I Love You. This is Paul Chambers and the Gentlemen. Thank you. The great Paul Chambers leading this date entitled Bass on Top. My guest, Henry Franklin's with us, just loving the blues as played by the great Paul Chambers, working with Kenny Burrell, playing a lot of rhythm guitar. Hank Jones at the piano, Arthur Taylor on drums. The tune, Confessing. I'm confessing that I love you, from 1957. You see our number on our screen. Give us a call if you wish. The Skipper is here to answer any and all questions about these wonderful musicians who have made music for so many years, made us all smile. Mm-hmm. You mentioned that Scott LaFaro and Paul Chambers, your two influences. There are others, obviously, but these two were way at the top of the list. Very different conceptions, different approaches. You want to speak to that briefly?
Yeah, they both had a different concept. Well, you just heard Paul. Like, Paul was more lyrical and more, I think, more in the pocket, more soulful, mm-hmm. as opposed to Scott LaFaro. Mm-hmm. And then when he picked up his bow to do Arco, I mean, that was it.
Am I safe in saying that he was the man with regard to the bow?
As far as I'm concerned, yes. Yeah.
Yeah. Just great stuff. Mm-hmm. There's so much music that I want to share with you, and the Skipper brought along his crew.
Yes.
So
yes.
Please stay tuned. Next up, just before the crew kicks in, I want to feature a band that I try to feature each and every semester because they play such an important role in the development of this music, their own, again, conception, the way they approached the music, the way they presented the music. I'm talking about the Modern Jazz Quartet, featuring one of the great basses, one of the great rocks of all time.
Percy Heath.
Percy Heath, exactly. So this is Milt Jackson on vibes, John Lewis at the piano, Percy Heath on bass, Connie Kay on drums, and I think, if I'm not mistaken, Bags himself, Milt Jackson, will introduce this next very, very famous tune. And we're going to come back with some surprises for you.
Next, we would like to play one of our jazz classics, Django. Thank you.
The Great Modern Jazz Quartet featured Milt Jackson on vibes, John Lewis on piano, Percy Heath on bass, and Connie Kay on drums. This was recorded, oh heavens, this was part of their 35th anniversary tour, recorded in 1987 in Germany. Modern Jazz Quartet, John Lewis's Django, in honor of the great gypsy guitarist Django Reinhardt. This is Jazz and Modern Era from the campus of Cal State Dominguez Hills. My principal guest, the one, the only, Henry the Skipper Franklin, who has left us for now, going to return. We're going to talk a little bit more, but more importantly, we're going to turn the band loose, and I'm going to take a moment to introduce these world-class musicians, and I say that with joy in my heart, and I'm truly honored to have these cats. These are the best of the best. The Henry Franklin Quartet, his crew that consists of, on saxophones, tenor and soprano, Mr. Chuck Manning has joined us. Chuck? At the keyboard, he has visited us on a couple of occasions. I was sharing with him earlier that, oh, 4 or 5 years ago, he and three other stalwarts came in with a tribute to Thelonious Monk. But he has rejoined us working with Henry Franklin. Mr. Theo Saunders has rejoined us. Theo, great to have you back. The leader of the pack, bassist supreme, the skipper himself, Mr. Henry Franklin, back there. The rock, the foundation. All three of the gentlemen I just introduced have graced our little room here before. This is a first for this next gentleman, a very special cat. One of the great trap drummers, one of the great timbaleros out there. This cat, along with his brother, all the music they've made over the years, among so many other gigs that he's made, truly a remarkable artist. Mr. Ramon Banda is with us this evening. Ramon. We're going to let these cats gig a little bit, and like I said, we're going to close our semester out with a bang. Feature of this great band, a tune written by Mr. Theo Saunders entitled Swala, which is Swahili for gazelle. Gentlemen, it's all yours. We'll be right back. Henry Franklin Quartet. The tune written by keyboardist Theo Saunders Swala. You can find this particular tune, as a matter, played by these very same gentlemen, on one of Henry Franklin's latest releases entitled The Soul of the World. He happened to bring a copy along. If you're in your record stores or you're on Amazon or probably CD Baby, you can probably find this particular date entitled again, The Soul of the World, Henry the Skipper Franklin. We're going to show it to you in just a moment. There it is. That's the skipper playing bass for the world, as you can see there on your screen. We're going to feature another tune that appears on this particular date, once again written by Mr. Theo Saunders, not only a remarkable keyboardist, but also composer supreme. This tune entitled Open Spaces, the Henry Franklin Quartet. We'll be right back. Straight ahead. On a Tuesday evening out of Cal State Dominguez Hills, Carson, California, I'm Chet Hanley, and this is Jazz in the Modern Era, if you just tuned in. We're featuring the Henry Franklin Quartet. Chuck Manning, in this case on tenor saxophone, Theo Saunders at the keyboard, the leader of the band, Mr. Henry Franklin on bass, and Mr. Traps himself, Mr. Ramon Banda, is stoking that fire. The name of the tune, Open Space, is written by Theo Saunders, and that tune also appears on one of Henry Franklin's latest releases entitled The Soul of the World. Pick it up, folks. Can't go wrong. You talk about an eclectic mix on this particular date. Check it out. You won't be disappointed. Throughout the remainder of the evening, and we'll be with you through 10 p.m., I'm going to share some other recordings by the gentlemen in this remarkable band, so please stay tuned. This next tune, written by saxophonist, composer supreme Wayne Shorter, and this tune also appears on The Soul of the World, the Henry Franklin aggravation, The Skipper and Crew. But before we do that, I do want to honor a few of you who phoned in. We appreciate your phone calls and your appreciation of this wonderful music. And I want to say it before I go any further. I hope you're hearing what I'm hearing out there in TV land, because I got the best seat in the house. Let's go to Cal from L.A. Cal, welcome to Jazz and Modern Era. Go ahead, please.
Yo, hey, Chet.
So yes.
A great look forward to Tuesdays, the high spot of the week when your show comes on.
Well, thank you, Cal.
And I want to say a big shout out to Henry and the gang. I'm Cal Bessemer. I played with Henry off and on, had the great pleasure over the last 20 years. I'm piano player. And I started off the mission gig with you. Henry, remember? I guess he's back from the stage yet there or not, but we started off that mission end thing together. First they said it was for a month, and they just kept extending it, and now for 11 years, so.
Wow. Cal, Henry is acknowledging everything you're saying right there in the pocket. Back in the good old days, indeed. I'm going to bring Henry back, and we're going to talk a little bit more about some of his projects and also talk about what you just shared about that great Mission End gig over the years. Great stuff.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Cal, it was a great time.
Oh, indeed. I can imagine playing with this man.
You know, when you work with Henry, it makes you remember why you wanted to be a jazz musician.
All right. Amen. I'll second that.
All right. Thanks for everything. God bless y'all.
Thank you, Cal, very, very much for calling. Really appreciate it. I love those calls that acknowledge these extraordinary musicians. And there's Cal, who actually worked with the Skipper. Good stuff. 800-339-1193 remains our number into our studio. And a reminder, it is toll free. Does that even apply anymore? I don't know. The age of cell phones and smartphones, I'm lost, totally lost in terms of technology. Anyway, we're going to carry on with this great quartet. Henry Franklin, Chuck Manning, Theo Saunders, Ramon Banda. They're going to play Wayne Shorter's Mahjong. Gentlemen. Thank you.
Thank you.
Of this music that some call jazz and others call just wonderful music, there are composers that stand out, among them the likes of Duke Ellington, Charles Mingus, Theo Saunders, Wayne Shorter, and we just featured Wayne Shorter line that I'm sure many of you who have loved Wayne's music over the years can connect with. I forget, was that on Juju? Was that originally on the album Juju? Anyway, from the 1960s, Mahjong, that's Wayne Shorter's tune, as played by the Henry Franklin Aggregation. Again, Chuck Manning on tenor saxophone, Theo Saunders at the keyboard, the leader Henry Franklin on bass, and Ramon Banda on drums. Just to give you an idea of the stature of these gentlemen, I do want to share the fact that all of them lead their own bands and are recording artists in their own right. And earlier I shared the Skipper's latest, entitled The Soul of the World. Well, keyboardist Theo Saunders had a recent release featuring some of the great local cats in his band, Zane Musa, David Dalston, Jeffrey Littleton, Tony Austin, with a surprise appearance by that master percussionist, Ray Armando. It's called Intergeneration, the Theo Saunders Sextet. And music that you can find in any... Chuck's on. Chuck. How could I forget Chuck? Saxophonist Chuck Manning's on this date as well. So check it out, the Theo Saunders Sextet, Intergeneration, just recently released. And just a quick note for your own edification. There's going to be another CD released by the Theo Saunders Aggregation taking place at the Crown Plaza Hotel. In and amongst those many hotels on Century Boulevard, the Crown Plaza features music every Thursday evening, or every other Thursday, or every Thursday. I think every other Thursday. Specifically, Thursday the 21st of this month, the Theo Saunders Band will be appearing at the Crown Plaza for yet another CD release. So if you've got some time after work, head on down to the Crown Plaza on Century Boulevard and check out Theo's band. You won't be disappointed. In addition, the gentleman on traps, Mr. Ramon Banda, this particular date, he's teamed up with his bassist brother, Tony Banda, the tune Acting Up. I think that's an appropriate title. The Banda Brothers feature some greats in the world of music, among them Chris Barron, Jolie De Leon, Javier Vergara, Francisco Torres, Papo Rodriguez, Alfred Ortiz, just a great, great group of cats coming together, and the Banda Brothers. Let's show this title to the gang out there in television land. Check this date out. Skipper said, why wasn't I on this date? They can settle that after we leave here this evening. Again, the Banda Brothers Acting Up, headed up by Tony and Ramon Banda. Great, great dates. We're going to play one more tune before we give you cats a rest. What you gonna play?
Love Song from
Midori. Love Song from Midori, also on His latest date, The Soul of the World. This is the Henry Franklin Quartet. Written by the leader of the day, Mr. Henry Franklin, I might add. Another prominent composer who should be included with the likes of Ellington and Mingus and Saunders and Shorter. It's yours, gentlemen. Take it away. Thank you.
Thank you.
that's pretty stuff. You know, in the annals of jazz, when you think composers, you think Ellington, Mingus, Saunders, Shorter, and Franklin. That's right. Beautiful, beautiful tune. I wanted to get up and start singing You Go to My Head, because it changes. Yeah, Love Song for Me, Dory, written by the leader of this band, Mr. Henry Franklin. Wonderful, wonderful music, I think you'll agree. We're going to give these cats a few moments to take a pause for the cause. I'm going to invite Henry back to the front here so we can talk a little bit more about this wonderful music you've been hearing. Again, the band, Chuck Manning, Theo Saunders, Ramon Banda, and Henry Franklin. This next video features one of Henry's contemporaries, one of the great bassists of all time. In fact, you heard the skipper mention this gentleman earlier on in the broadcast. Truly a virtuoso on the bass, Mr. Ron Carter. In solo fashion, we're going to go back to 1984, feature Ron on a tune entitled Willow Weep for Me. This is Ron Carter by himself. Thank you. The most recorded bassist in music history, Mr. Ron Carter. I featured Ron Carter on any number of occasions in past weeks, working with his own band, working, of course, in the second great Miles Davis Quintet from the 60s, and in this case, working with Herbie Hancock and Billy Cobham in Switzerland, 1984. And Ron's interpretation of Willow Weep for Me in solo fashion. A good friend of Ron Carter is to my left. Mr. Henry, the Skipper Franklin, has joined us for our final broadcast. And what a great way to go out and hopefully look forward to the fall of 2011. Skipper, again, yes. Thank you so much, man, for joining us, man.
This thank you for having us.
Fantastic, man.
This is an honor for us. Oh, thank you.
Ron Carter. You were sharing some things while the audience was watching that about how you cats are close and they're such a great cast.
Pretty close, yeah. Well, I've known Ron since 1971. Met him at the Monterey Jazz Festival. I was working there with Sonny Rollins, and he was, I forgot who he was with, but I met him backstage, and he knew I was nervous, and he knew I was a youngster and all that stuff. He's only about, I guess, 5 years apart, but of course he's got the experience, especially at that time. And he just was very, very warm, you know. And we've been friends ever since.
I know you said you've been exchanging.
Yeah, I send him my humble CD efforts, and he sends me his stuff. And,
great.
We talk about strings, and he sends me strings. He sends me some. Strings ain't cheap either, man.
Okay.
So I really appreciate that.
Oh, indeed. Absolutely.
But he gives me a lot of advice when I ask for it. And, he's always there.
All right.
He's a master musician, master bass player, great writer.
That's right.
Yeah,
in the history of jazz,
there you go.
In terms of composers, Duke Ellington,
right.
Charles Mingus,
yeah.
Wayne Shorter, Theo Simon, Henry Franklin, Ron Carter.
Ron Carter.
Absolutely. Great stuff. The Skipper's here in Carson, California. I'm so glad that you joined us for our final broadcast of the spring 2011. Let me take a moment, if I may, to acknowledge some very, very special people who have assisted throughout the semester in bringing you these broadcasts, all 15 of them. Beginning with a lady who has helped direct, she's helped do graphics, you name it, she's there. Miss Brittany Uribe is back there doing her thing. Mr. Ron Estrada. Ron does it all. He answers the phones. He does graphics. He's there for us all the time. So, Ron, many, many thanks. One of our newcomers working in the control room, Ms. Chita Chen, is with us. Chita is co-directing this evening and helped last week with direction. And I have it on good authority, if all goes according to plan, that she's going to be back with us next semester. So, Chita, thank you so much. A very, very, very special thank you to a lady who's been with us now the last couple of years, and she's directed this program on any number of occasions. She is a jewel, an absolute jewel. We're going to miss her when she moves on, but I'm sure that her future is assured, given her remarkable skills at directing, at doing all that it takes to roll out these broadcasts. Miss Angie Garduño, Angie, many, many thanks to you. To the gentleman I've worked with for the last, good Lord, 20 years in distance learning, the gentleman who heads up distance learning out here at Cal State Dominguez Sears, Dr. Warren Ashley. Warren's been working with us the last several weeks, and it's always a pleasure to interact with Warren. He's always got words of wisdom for us, and he's there to support the students who work the control room. So, Warren, many thanks to you. And finally, to Mr. Van Bridgman, who has directed this program for the last 8.5, 9 years. And he couldn't join us for this week's broadcast, but Van is there in spirit, and I did want to acknowledge all of Van's efforts over the years, and it's truly, truly appreciated. Thank you all for helping out. And I can't do any of this stuff without their help, so again, thank you. All right, Skipper, with the next selection goes back a few years, specifically roughly 1968, when you were just a young pup, huh?
You got that right.
And this date and the tune in particular is an award winner. And all of you out there have heard this tune on any number of occasions. It's been covered by any number of artists, including people like the Friends of Distinction, among many, many others. But this is the original version from the date entitled The Promise of a Future, 1968, the bassist on this date, the gentleman to my left, Mr. Henry Franklin. The tune is Grazing in the Grass. Recollect, Henry, if you would, that particular date. Any thoughts come to mind putting that date together with the great Hugh Masekela?
Well, yeah, it was really funny. I was in the band had been together, I guess about a year before we did that record.
Mm-hmm.
We were doing the date, I remember it was at Gold Star Studios in Hollywood, and we had almost completed the date, and we needed one more tune. Yeah, this is that story. We needed one more tune to put on there, so Huey said, well, I remember this old tune that an old song we used to do in South Africa. Mm-hmm. It was like I guess you would call it a standard or a folk song or something.
Yeah.
Like that. Kind of folk song. And so he hummed it out and said, put some changes out there for us. There's only four changes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so it was a very simple tune.
Yeah.
So he said, let's roll it, let's do it.
And the rest is history.
And the rest is history.
Amazing.
Yeah,
it's interesting how things happen. You said, it was almost an afterthought.
Exactly.
That's, had room for one more.
Exactly. That's why I believe to this day that you can't try to plan for a hit. It's just got to come naturally.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
A lot of people try to change their ideas and their playing to try to make a hit, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think it works that way.
Well, again, I think it kind of connects with this whole notion of the music that we've been sharing for the last 15 weeks. Spontaneity, improvisation, kind of, hey,
here it is. Here's some changes. Let's play it. Hum out the tune and add some elements to it and play.
I believe you got to be true to the music and be true to what you, your belief in the music, and it'll take care of you.
By the way, a quick aside before we play this tune that I'm sure you'll recognize immediately. You probably have it in your library. If you were with me last week, my colleague and friend for many, many years, Mr. Jeffrey Winston, joined me, and we put the spotlight on Jefferson High School in general and the great teacher from Jeff back in the good old days, Dr. Samuel Brown. And so many great, great musicians came out of Jefferson and were mentored by Sam Brown and Alma Hightower, among others. Well, just know that the gentleman to my left is also a product of LA Unified Schools. You know, LA Unified Schools takes a lot of heat, but LA Unified Schools also turns out some extraordinary people, as evidenced by the academic decathlon winners a few days ago, national academic decathlon winners, and an alumnus of LA High School and Manual Arts High School, seated right here, Mr. Henry Franklin. So a shout out to LA Unified. Hang in there, folks. Public education is taking a lot of heat these days, but they do indeed turn out some extraordinary people, and one is to my left. This is Umasa Kalis grazing in the grass, and we'll come back. I'm sure you recognize that. No, I'm not Umasa Kalis. That's Umasa Kalis behind me. Over my left shoulder, Umasa Kalis leading this band from, 1968. And the band at that particular time on this classic, Grazing in the Grass, Al Abreu, tenor saxophone, William Henderson at the piano, Bruce Langhorne on guitar, and Chuck Carter on drums. Grazing in the Grass, from the date entitled The Promise of the Future, goes back to 1968, a classic, and the bassist on this date, Mr. Henry Franklin. A quick note that those of you enrolled, you should expect to find your grades on Blackboard. As the semester closes out, I will be posting them on Blackboard. And again, I regret that those of you who are enrolled who never responded to my pleas to A, tell me who the artist you were going to be profiling is or was, nor did I receive a project from you. So, folks, what can I tell you? On the upside, I'm going to turn the evening back over to this extraordinary band. Let me introduce the Cats once again. This is the Henry Franklin Quartet. The drummer extraordinaire, Mr. Ramon Banda, is with us at Trap Kid. Ramon, thank you. On tenor saxophone and soprano, if you were with us at the top, you heard the great Chuck Manning on soprano saxophone, but he's playing tenor now as we speak. At that big Kurzweil sitting over there, Mr. Theo Saunders. In the history of jazz, and the leader of this band, the one, the only, the skipper is here, Mr. Henry Franklin. They're going to kick off the second set with a tune written by one of my favorite people of all time, one of the greatest saxophonists in history, in my humble opinion. I recall, as I mentioned earlier, several years ago, Theo Saunders, among others, was here with this gentleman who wrote this tune to play the music of Thelonious Monk. I'm talking about the late, great Herman Riley. He wrote this tune entitled Mama Lela, and we're going to feature this tune first up from the Henry Franklin Quartet. Gentlemen. We'll be right back. Caribbean. I should talk with my Caribbean lilt, but I don't dare. Written by the great Herman Riley, one of my all-time heroes who left us a few years ago, but his legacy will live forever. The tune Mama Lela is performed by the Henry Franklin Quartet. And on that particular tune, all the cats were featured, but in particular on drums, Mr. Ramon Banda. Stirring solo. In case you're wondering, folks, Ramon, who with his brother toured with Poncho Sanchez's band for a year. How many years, Ramon? 20-something? Yeah. 20-plus years with Poncho Sanchez's band, Ramon and Tony Banda. Is Tony still with the band?
Yeah.
Yeah, Tony Banda, his brother, is still touring with Poncho Sanchez. Poncho plays here locally often, but tours throughout. Anyway, it's a pleasure to have these cats. And Ramon, that was a stunning solo, man. Great stuff. We're going to carry on with this great quartet, and they're going to do a tune entitled 16 Tons. This tune is featured on an album I shared with you earlier, Theo Saunders' Date, entitled Intergenerational. Why do I want to put the AL on there? I guess I'm seeing things. Intergeneration, the Theo Saunders Sextet. This is 16 Tons, as performed by the Henry Franklin Quartet. We'll be right back. the tune, 16 Tons, as interpreted by the Henry Franklin Quartet. Another interpretation is on Bill Saunders, one of his more recent dates entitled Intergeneration. And you'll find it there, and it features Chuck Manning, as a matter of fact, on this date and tune. So pick it up. Theo Saunders Sextet, Intergeneration. Theo's with us, working with Henry Franklin, Chuck Manning, and Ramon Banda. Before this great band goes to the next tune, I do want to make a couple of announcements. I stand corrected, ladies and gentlemen. I made a mistake earlier on this evening in announcing Theo Saunders and his band and their upcoming appearance at the Crown Plaza. I indicated that it's on the 21st. Wrong. If you go on the 21st, which is a Saturday, you may see somebody, but you won't find Theo Saunders and his band. They are appearing rather on the 19th, Thursday the 19th of May. CD release party, Theo Saunders Sextet. So again, please make that correction, make that note. A mistake I made earlier. It's the 19th, not the 21st of May. And you hit it what time, Theo, roughly?
Seven
o'clock they hit at the Crown Plaza on Century Boulevard. Also another announcement. I don't think I made this announcement earlier. Our great percussionist this evening, Mr. Ramon Banda, is appearing with one of the great masters of the B3 Hammond organ, Mr. Joy DeFrancesco, at Steamers Cafe in Fullerton. They are appearing on the 27th and 28th of this month, right, Ramon? And I hope those dates are correct. 27th and 28th, check your local listings just to be certain. Ramon Banda featured with Joey DeFrancesco. That ought to be a stirring date. Is it a trio or a quartet?
Yeah, Rick
Zuniger. Rick Zuniger on guitar. Rick has been here. Wow, I think he came in with Charlie Owens a few years back. That was fun. All right. One other announcement, and you need to get a pencil and paper out because I want all of you out there listening to order all of these dates, but in particular, since our principal guest this evening is the skipper, Mr. Henry Franklin, the date I shared with you earlier entitled The Soul of the World, and also a very recent release entitled Shanghai, where the skipper is working in trio fashion with Bob Mokarski and Chris. Pronounce his last name for me, Skipper, please. Chris is on the date. No matter the names, this music is wonderful stuff. Of course, featuring the Skipper on bass.
In Shanghai,
recorded in Shanghai. And again, a very, very recent release. You can pick up these dates if you connect directly with the Skipper. I'm going to give you a phone number. He gave me permission to provide this phone number for you. If you are at all interested in picking up these dates, and it's a strong recommendation I have to call this number, get this music in your library. The number is as follows, area code 951-943-4740. Let me say it again. 951 area code, the phone number, 943-4740. And time permitting, we'll announce that phone number again before we leave here. Order these dates. You will not be disappointed, folks. These are some of the best cats in the land making this wonderful music. And I am truly appreciative and honored to have them out joining us for our very last broadcast. I told you we're going to take it out with a bang. This next tune, a traditional folk song as interpreted by some jazz masters. They're going to interpret Hi Lily, Hi Lily, Hi Lo. This is the Henry Franklin Quartet. Thank you. composer of this tune, Mr. Bronislaw Caper, would be proud at that version of his classic. I call it a folk tale, if you will. Hi, Lily, Hi, Lily, Hi, Lo, as interpreted by the Henry Franklin Quartet. And you'll find that tune also on his latest date that I shared with you earlier, entitled The Soul of the World. In this case, Chuck Manning playing soprano saxophone, Theo Saunders at the keyboard, Mr. Ramon Banda on drums, and the skipper, Henry Franklin, on bass. As we carry on, so much music, so little time. We only have about a half an hour left, folks. I'm having a grand old time, and my hope is that you are as well. I better hurry up with this half an hour because my voice is starting to leave. But we're going to give this band one more break and let them take the program out as we approach the 10 o'clock hour. Our final video showcase for the evening, we're going to stretch out and let Elvin Jones's Jazz Machine do a little workout on a tune written by his brother Thad Jones entitled Ray L. And this band at the time in 1991 features some stalwarts, one of whom was a very young, not just beginning, but really becoming known. Obviously a very, very famous family. Elvin Jones's Jazz Machine at the time in 91 featured Mr. Sonny Fortune and Ravi Coltrane, a very young Ravi Coltrane on saxophones and flute, Mr. Chip Jackson on bass, Chicago's own Willie Pickens on piano, and the master Elvin Jones on drums. The tune Ray L, we're going to stretch, and then we'll come back and let this great band close it out. Elvin Jones Jazz Machine, recorded live in 91, Stuttgart, Germany. And the band at the time, of course, the dynamic, legendary leader, Mr. Elvin Jones, leading this great band on drums. The Reed Men, Sonny Fortune, and Ravi Coltrane. The pianist, Willie Pickens. The bassist, Chip Jackson. And, of course, again, the drummer, Mr. Elvin Jones. The tune written by Elvin's brother, Thad Jones, called Rael. Great stuff. Strong recommendation. If you see Elvin Jones's Jazz Machine in your record shop or online, grab it. Grab it quickly. I have been honored, ladies and gentlemen, this evening and having some very, very special cats who come and join me this evening. Three of the four have appeared here before, and they actually came back. So that truly does my heart well. Just a last mention of some of the tunes that have been played. In fact, many of the tunes that have been played are featured on Henry Franklin's, one of his latest releases entitled The Soul of the World. And I might add that in addition to the cats who are here this evening on the band, old friend Nolan Shaheed, recording engineer, world-class middle distance runner and great trumpeter, also appears on this particular date, along with the phenomenal Gilbert Castellanos. So again, strong recommendation to check it out. Let's take one quick phone call and then we'll return to this great band and move forward. For the last time this semester, Mike from Sherman Oaks. Mike, welcome back.
Hey, Chad, how we doing?
Oh, man, I'm doing
Show's
great.
Show's great as always.
Thank you, Mike. I appreciate the kind words as always. Thanks.
And it's the last show for the season, right?
Regretfully,
I'm
just tuning
in now. Unfortunately, I got in pretty late tonight. So, I mean, I couldn't tune in as regular as I intend to. So when is the next show starting?
Well, my hope, Mike, and again, I'm assuming that we will return in the fall. And, you know, one never knows, do one. If we hit again in the fall, it'll either be just prior to Labor Day or the Tuesday after Labor Day. My only suggestion is check your listings. You can check Cal State Dominguez Hills' website, csudh.edu. And check it out. Or, like a lot of folks do, around that time, and we've aired on Tuesdays for many, many years now, I turn it on at 9 o'clock on Tuesdays and see if we appear.
Okay, Jed, I got it. Okay, it's always a pleasure.
My pleasure indeed, Mike. Mike is a longtime viewer. And, again, Mike, thank you for staying with us throughout and your kind words. And what a great way. The last phone call from Mike, who's been with us now as long as we've been on the air. The band, Chuck Manning on tenor saxophone, Theo Saunders at the keyboard, the great Henry Franklin on bass, and the dynamic Ramon Banda on drums. Are we going to play Shema?
Mm-hmm.
All right. This tune, written by keyboardist extraordinaire Mr. Theo Saunders, entitled Shema. It's a North African term for hot desert wind.
This is the name.
Oh, it's the name of the hot desert wind. I'm getting an education from this gentleman, as I always do when he comes and joins us. This is the Henry Franklin Quartet. One, two, three.
Thank you.
Shemal, written by Theo Saunders, as we close out another rip-roaring semester. So glad you could join us throughout. Looking forward to the fall, assuming that we come back in the fall. We're going to close things out with a little blues by this great band. Thanks, fellas. See you next semester.